Tesla's Gigafactory Texas-built Model Y will feature the company's structural battery pack and the revolutionary 4680 battery, CEOs Elon Musk confirmed on the company's Q4 2021 earnings call. Tesla said it was still working to finalize production schedules for its Gigafactory Berlin and Texas, with the location of the next factory likely to be announced by the end of 2022. Elon Musk is confident that full self-driving will be complete by the end of the year. Tesla's product roadmap update, on the other hand, revealed that the Cybertruck and the $25,000 model won't be available in 2022. Welcome back to Technopol. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, like this video, and leave us a comment below with the topics you would like to see in our next videos. Musk confirmed that Tesla has been building several Model Y units at the Gigafactory Texas in recent days as the factory nears production approval. After updating the audience that Tesla will begin deliveries of the Texas-built Model Y once the vehicle has received a certificate of approval, Musk confirmed that the 4680 cell and structural battery pack system will be used in vehicles built at the Texas Gigafactory. Tesla updated the timeline for the plant in its shareholder deck by stating, builds of Model Ys started in late 2021 at Gigafactory Texas. After final certification of Austin-made Model Y, we plan to start deliveries to customers. Interestingly, Tesla also stated in its Q4 2021 shareholder presentation that the Model Y, built at the Gigafactory Berlin in Germany, will not initially have a 4680 battery. The vehicles will initially be equipped with 2170 battery cells that have been used in the Model 3 and Model Y since the early days of production. The 4680 battery is designed to revolutionize lithium-ion batteries used in electric vehicles. At 46 mm wide and 80 mm long, it has 5 times the energy density, 16% more range, and 6 times the power output. The unit has been in development since 2020 and is located behind the door of the Cotta Road facility. Drew Baglino, Tesla's senior vice president of powertrain for Tesla, said that 4680 cells are not a constraint to our 2022 volume plans. He added that he expects the first 4680 battery-equipped vehicles to be delivered by the end of the first quarter of 2022. Musk also confirmed that the Gigafactory Texas Model Ys will feature structural battery packs, which will increase the rigidity and structural integrity of the vehicle. Tesla hinted at the structural package included in the car when it released the shareholder deck ahead of the earnings call. Structural battery packs work like airplane wings and will improve the structural integrity of Tesla vehicles. While casting improves manufacturing efficiency and strength, the positioning of the structural cells eliminates redundant structure from the battery pack, thereby increasing density. The non-cell portion of the battery has negative mass, Musk said. We saved more mass in the rest of the vehicle than in the non-cell portion of the battery. So how do you really minimize the mass of the battery, make it negative? The idea is that individual cells can be positioned more efficiently because the excess structure of the battery pack itself is eradicated. The new structural battery pack design is completely free of any negative mass, resulting in increased battery pack density and structural integrity. It only makes the vehicle safer, already improving the world-class crash safety rating that Tesla has across its product line. Now that Model Y vehicles being manufactured at Gigafactory Texas are confirmed to have the structural battery pack and 4680 cells, Tesla's long-standing projects to revolutionize castings and EV battery tech are here. Tesla has updated the production schedule for the company's two new production facilities, the Gigafactory Berlin and Gigafactory Texas. While Tesla is still close to initial production from each factory, the automaker has not given a specific date to start production because approval ultimately rests with the various jurisdictions where the factories are located. Gigafactory Berlin was scheduled to start production at the end of 2021, but the approval process did not advance in time to make it happen. Instead, Tesla has pushed back initial production to 2022 and still doesn't have a firm start date, according to the automaker's shareholder presentation ahead of its fourth quarter 2021 earnings call. Tesla said, "Equipment testing through the vehicle production process started late 2021. We are still in the process of finalizing the manufacturing permit from local authorities, which will allow us to start delivering German-made vehicles in Europe. These first vehicles will be built using 2170 cells. Unfortunately, the first Model Y units at the Berlin Gigafactory won't feature Tesla's 4680 batteries, as they don't appear to be ready for initial production. Tesla did share new photos of the Berlin production line and quality checks, though. Additionally, Tesla shared a photo of the seat mounted on its structural battery pack, which was recently added to the Model Y owner's manual. Tesla may already be launching two new vehicle factories this year in the form of Gigafactory Texas and Giga Berlin, but the company still appears to be in its infancy. During the recent fourth quarter and full year 2021 earnings call, CEOs Elon Musk noted that while Tesla isn't ready to announce the location of its next factory today, it could be the case by the end of the year. A look at Musk's statements during the Q4 and full year 2021 earnings call hints that Tesla could be considering multiple locations for more than one new factory this year. Interestingly, Musk did not dub these upcoming facilities as Gigafactories outright, which may suggest that some of these new plants may be modeled after the company's other projects, like its Megafactory in Lathrop, California. Given the challenges and delays the company is facing at Gigafactory Berlin, Tesla may be choosing the location of the new factory more carefully. While Giga Berlin was built quickly due to the use of early approvals, the final permit for the facility will take a considerable amount of time before it is issued. Local groups opposed to the facility have also presented one legal challenge after another to the project. For its next factory, it wouldn't be surprising if Tesla decides to build operations in places it can move quickly and openly, such as Texas in the US or Shanghai in China. From a financial standpoint, Tesla's fourth quarter and full year 2021 earnings call were the most impressive in its history. After reporting its second profitable year of operation with healthy auto gross margins and above consensus production and delivery figures, Tesla has drawn broad bullish commentary from many analysts and companies. But the most anticipated part is Musk's promise to update Tesla's product roadmap, which shows that Cybertruck, Semi, Roadster, and Optimus will not come until 2023 at the earliest. So we will not be introducing new vehicle models this year, Musk said on the call. It would not make any sense because we'll still be parts constrained. Global supply chain issues have been plaguing the automotive industry. Interestingly, Tesla appears to be a company that seems desperate to avoid increasing wait times for even the most standard parts. However, the company isn't immune to shortages, and 2022 won't be the year Tesla launches any new cars, including the Cybertruck, which was recently rumored to be delayed until 2023. It appears the reports are correct that Tesla won't be entering any definitive stage of production for the Cybertruck, nor any of the other models Musk mentioned this year. The Roadster, Semi, and the rumored $25,000 car won't go into production anytime in 2022, but that doesn't mean Tesla won't develop them. We will, however, do a lot of engineering and tooling, whatnot to create those vehicles, Cybertruck, Semi, Roadster, Optimus, and be ready to bring those to production hopefully next year. That is most likely, Musk added. He also indicated that the Tesla bot, which is inching toward the name Optimum Subprime, will be Tesla's most important product development of 2022. This, I think, has the potential to be more significant in the vehicle business over time. While some are frustrated by the time delay, it's important to remember that Tesla has no control over global supply constraints. While the company is super vertically integrated, it can't build the entire car itself and has to source some parts from third-party suppliers. This has limited Tesla's ability to offer certain powertrains and has delayed delivery dates for some currently offered models. What about those models that have been on Tesla's production line for years? The Cybertruck's tri-motor powertrain has an initial production date of late 2021. Now, according to Musk himself, the tri-motor won't even be the vehicle of choice, saying the quad-motor variant will be the first Cybertruck to be produced at Gigafactory Texas. Tesla's uber-affordable $25,000 model will also not be coming anytime soon, although he confirmed it. Well, we're not currently working on a $25,000 car. You know, at some point, we will, but we have enough on our plate right now, too much on our plate, frankly. So you know, at some point, there will be, Musk said. The Q4 2021 earnings call did tell us one thing. Good things are coming next year. This year will be the year to get through supply chain shortages, which Musk also said will continue into this year. So, in 2022, the supply chain will continue to be the fundamental limiter of output across all factories. So the chip shortage, while better than last year, is still an issue. After Tesla resolves the short-term issue of supply chain bottlenecks, the company's long-term project can move forward, bringing more groundbreaking and innovative electric vehicles to the market car. Musk is very confident in his prediction, saying he will be shocked if Tesla doesn't get the FSD by the end of the year. Tesla's full self-driving kit has been in development for several years and is expected to be feature complete a few years ago. However, Tesla is close to solving its conundrum, except for one feature, autonomous driving on city streets. According to the company's fourth quarter 2021 shareholder report, Tesla has opened a beta program for FSD that has amassed more than 60,000 active users. The full self-driving kit is currently priced at $12,000, up from $10,000 on January 17. Tesla confused many when it raised the price of the kit, but didn't release any improvements or new features to regular FSD users, not just those who were in the beta program. However, the price hike may indicate Musk's confidence in the FSD kit, which many predicted after the price hike because it didn't give a general explanation. Musk said the day after the price hike, "People do not yet understand how valuable an autonomous vehicle will be." While Musk's outline of the plan is invaluable, consumers seem to believe that they wanted to pay for what was available now and not necessarily the capabilities of the program. But if Musk's predictions are correct, skeptics will eat their words. Tesla can finally release a features complete FSD kit, especially considering the CEO revealed the Dojo supercomputer, which will surely take the company's autonomous exploration in the right direction, which is not required to complete FSD. Instead, Musk hinted at Dojo's different plans. "If Dojo is competitive, it is the kind of thing we might offer to other companies," Musk said. That's all for this video about Tesla, and thank you for watching. If you'd like to receive more updates, make sure you click the subscribe and bell icon and leave a comment because it really matters.